Again, more than 60 of the tri-state's top clay artists will be in one place. I believe they're ceramicists. The Clay Alliance's Spring Fair, and here to tell us more about it is a ceramicist herself, Laura Davis, one of the volunteers who also runs Core Clay. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, exciting. So what'd you bring for us to look at?
Well, we've got quite a few pieces this year.
Yeah.
We have a full range of potters there. We have artists that do sort of functional work, very functional work.
That's a bean pot,
you
said?
That's a bean pot by Dennis Allen from Whistle Creek.
Great. That's this one, and actually for beans?
And that is actually from my own collection that I eat food out of.
Oh, so, fantastic.
Yeah. And then my very favorite mug is a Marsha Cochran mug that I just love. It makes me feel happy and calm when I eat out of it.
Well, that's good to be happy and calm. I think yours is lovely. This is Laura's.
That's my own work.
A lot of detail going into this one. I'll put it up over here. You know, my mom used to throw pots, and I know that putting these delicate lines in it becomes very...
It's tricky.
Tricky.
Yeah, and sometimes you cut right through,
mm-hmm.
and it's a brand new glaze that we developed by accident when my assistant blended two buckets together by accident.
Well,
so
it was
the happiest
serendipitous.
Accident we've ever had.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Fantastic. And then what about this character?
That is a garden gnome by Linda Legendre. I
garden gnome.
Love her garden gnome.
Sarah,
this
here.
Is a little mug that... If you ever see her own mugs, the full-size ones, the handles are made out of lizards. And so it's a little mini mug. And then
mini
in the
lizard.
Pocket,
there's lizard,
another one. And
lizard.
They're just, they're so detailed, and they just keep going and going and going.
Goodness. And then I almost hesitate to even talk about it because you've told me the cost of this thing. What's that?
That is a piece by Terry Kern, and we are raffling that off. It's a $2,200 piece. It is a dollar for a ticket.
Here,
or
take the top off so they can
see.
I'm not going to touch it.
The top comes off.
Oh, beautiful.
It is so detailed. She does this with the tiniest little brushes. Millions, I swear, millions of little strokes.
Brush strokes.
And if you can see in, they just, the detail goes on and on and on. And then each of these little pieces has another image inside it, and there's a dragon on it, and
neat.
It just keeps going, and there's a whole narrative behind it that Terry will tell you if you win.
And so the raffle, you can get a raffle ticket at the fair.
Yes.
Which is on Cinco de Mayo.
Cinco de Mayo.
At DeSales
at
Corner.
At DeSales Corner. From
all
11
along
to
the
5.
Street there from 11 to 5
yes.
in Walnut Hills on May 5th.
The day before the pig.
The day before the pig, next week. Well,
and
thank
I
you so
understand
much
we're
going
to have perfect weather for it.
We are trying to work with the meteorology crew over there to ensure that's going to happen.
Perfect.
Laura, thanks
thank
so much
you.
For coming in. Good to see
thanks.
You again. Yeah.